Hello everyone, welcome back to Owen's Treats. Today we'll be working on Fandom Week. So for Fandom Week, we'll be doing three separate treats inspired by three separate fandoms. Our first treat is going to be inspired by My Neighbor Totoro. If you don't know what My Neighbor Totoro is, it's basically an anime from the Studio Ghibli. And as you can see, I'm wearing my onesie and I'm holding my plush. So, let's get started. We will be making hard-boiled egg animals inspired with Totoro. You will need three large eggs, 2 cups of lukewarm water, a small saucepan, toothpicks, toasted sesame seeds, make sure they're toasted, soy sauce. You will need a small container. You'll also be needing a spoon. And off to the side, I have a bowl of ice water that we'll be saving for later. Water. And we're going to dump it into our small saucepan. What we're first going to be needing to do is we're going to take our egg, we're going to take the bottom end of it, and we're going to put the bottom part of it like this, take a firm grasp with your hand, and then take your other hand, and make sure you also have a firm grasp and a needle, and you're just going to poke on the needle through.
Okay, so now that our water is going to a boil, you're going to take a device,
or I have a little measuring spoon, I guess you can say, and we're going to take our egg. We're going to put it inside, and then we're going to slowly lower it in. We're going to do this with each egg. And make sure your eggs are room temperature, so they don't disrupt the boil.
We're going to let them go for 12 minutes, then we're going to take them out, and then we're going to set them in an ice bath for another 2 minutes. Eggs have been boiling in the water for 12 minutes. We're gonna scoop them out and then we're gonna put them in an ice water mixture.
And we let our eggs set in the ice water for at least 5 minutes. They're not all nice and cool and you can touch them, which is good. We're going to take our spoon and we're gonna start cracking them, peeling them, whatever you wanna call it. And then we're gonna move on to our dyeing step. So let's start cracking. You just want to take the back of your spoon and you kind of want to hit it a couple times. And you're going to peel back the shell of the egg. You want to be really slow and you want to take it piece by piece. And there we go. Now that I have our egg all nice and peeled, I'm going to dry it off. And we're going to set it aside onto another piece of napkin or into a bowl. And then after we got all our eggs deshelled or peeled, we're going to move on to dye. So after we just cracked and peeled our eggs, we are then going to dye them with soy sauce. Now that we have our soy sauce inside our container, we're going to take 1 or 2 eggs, we're going to submerge one whole, and then we're going to take one, you have our cutting board and a sharp knife, make sure you have parent supervision. And then we're going to slice it on the side like this. We're going to take this one slice part, and then we're going to dip into our soy sauce. We're going to dye them for 5 minutes on each side, and then we're going to turn them again. And then after they're done dyeing, we're going to get moving on our next step. We're going to set our dyeing eggs aside, and we're going to take our last egg that we had. And we're going to take our sharp knife, make sure you're careful with this, and then we're just going to cut at like a 45 degree angle down the middle of it. So you create this kind of cut, I don't know if it shows up on camera. And then we're going to do it on this opposite side, and then we're going to follow that until they meet. And then you can just kind of take the cut out, and then if it looks a little messy, you can simply just use your knife and cut anything out. And you just kind of scoop it out, if need be. Keep the yolk in there. And there we go. That is one of our eggs partially done. Now we're going to move on to our stained egg. Now our stained egg has been sitting in soy sauce for about 5 minutes on each side. Now you're going to take out your egg. And you're just gonna dry it off with a paper towel. You just kind of want to squeeze it. and then you have kind of a brown egg. And you just want to pull anything off. And then we're going to take our separate egg. This one that we've been letting go inside soy sauce. Moving on to decoration. I'm setting down for this part because it's just easier for me. So we have our sesame seeds, we have the toothpicks, and I also have one carrot here. This is optional. You don't have to do this part, but I like to use the carrot. And then we're going to pop up in our sesame seeds. We're going to kind of just sprinkle some on the board. And then we're going to take our toothpicks. We're going to take one out. And then we're going to cut off the bottom so it sits like that. And you see, with the stained one, it doesn't go all the way in through. It only goes to the outer rim, so it's not as soy saucy. We're going to take our sesame seeds. And we're just going to kind of pluck one or two on here. As for the eyes. And you just kind of want to use your toothpick and you want to just put them into place. Now you can dig a hole for this part and then add them in. I just like placing them on with my finger and then using the toothpick to direct them to the spot. Now we have our two cute little eyes on our egg. We're going to do this to our sheepy and then we're going to stick some more sesame seeds onto our sheepy one. So you can have them as cute as you want. And then we're going to take our carrot, we're going to take our sharp knife, wipe anything off on a paper towel, and we're going to be very careful, and we're going to cut a thin slice of our carrot. Just going to go on the rim. And they're going to cut that carrot in half. And this will be one pair of whiskers for Totoro. And you kind of want to add them in almost an arrow shape on his face. Sort of like this. These will act as his whiskers. And you want to cut another thin slice. So then we're just going to add our whiskers to the other side. And we got our other side done. And then we're going to take our scraps of carrot that we used. And we're going to stick them on his belly. I'm going to shape mine and then I'm going to add. And I'm actually going to add slits for this part, just so they fit in easier. And once again, you can use your toothpick, and you just kind of push them in. Here we go. Good Mickey. And then for our last step, we're just going to take our knife, we're going to keep the very sharp pointy edge, point away from us, and on the top of our head, we're just going to cut out sort of like an ear shape on top. And we're going to take our extra egg that we dyed, and we're going to cut off a very small piece. And we're going to split them in two. And we're going to take our toothpick, and then we're going to jam this little piece underneath the ear flap that we made. So it gives it more depth when you look at it. And there we go. That is our Totoro egg. And here's our sheepy egg. Thank you all for joining. I'm gonna make a whole lot more of these. This is part two of our fandom series. So for part two of our fandom series, we are doing Yoda Soda. So I have my Star Wars themed sweatshirt here. And I also have, hey, what are you guys doing here? No? Wait. Hey, what are you guys doing inside? No. Anyways, besides them, we're going to be working with Yoda Soda. Let's get started with the ingredients. Green food coloring, sherbet lime, and we're also going to need Sprite, or you can do lemon or lime seltzer, whichever one you prefer. We're going to take the lid off of our blender. We're going to be using our Sprite, and we also have our sherbet lime ice cream. The first thing to do is we're going to take our pop of choice, and we're going to pour it into our blender, the entire can. And then we also have our sherbet lime. After we have our drink of choice inside our blender, we're going to add about, I'm going to say half a cup. Half a cup of our sherbet. So for our blending, we're not going to go full blend. We're just going to kind of whip it for
about maybe 30 seconds. And we're also going to add in our green food color.
There we go.
We don't want too much green, but we do want it green. And then we're just going to blitz this for a little bit. And there we go.
So we're going to take this mug.
Now this mug has all the iconic characters on it. And we're just going to pour it in. And you cannot forget the form. We're going to take one more scoop. And you're just going to want to plop it in there. Just like that. And then to finish this all off, one festive green straw. We have everything out of the way. Including you guys. Off, shoot. And there we go. We have our Yoda soda. In continuation of our Fandom series, this is now part 3. What we're going to be making today, Thor's hammer. So what we'll be needing is large pretzel rods, jumbo marshmallows, 6 cups of Rice Krispies, a loaf pan, cooking spray.
Now we're on the stovetop, we also have a very large pan.
I also forgot to mention 4 tablespoons of butter. So we're going to heat our pan on the low. Butter and the sauce. And we're just gonna be basically just stirring the butter around until it's fully melted. Now that it looks like our butter is almost completely melted, we're gonna be adding our marshmallows. Now we're gonna add at least half the butter. We're gonna take a couple handfuls of marshmallows and we're just gonna drop them. We can always add more later. We're going to increase the heat just by a little bit, and we're gonna start stirring. And then you want to kind of lower the heat when you see them start to melt. So turn off the heat, and then take it off. So now we're just going to take off the heat and move it off to the side. Still stirring. And now that our marshmallows are melted, we're going to start a little bit at a time. We have the 6 cups of Rice Krispies. Now that our Rice Krispies, marshmallows, and butter are all combined, we're going to move back to the table. You want to keep stirring them and make sure that they're still hot. You do not want these to cool down because they will be a pain to get out. Cooking spray and line the inside. And then pouring our Rice Krispies into our prepared recipe. Now we're going to use the back of a wooden spoon and try to flatten this all out and pull it to the corners. There you go. Now that we have it mostly packed in, I'm going to wash my hands, and then we'll move on to our final step. Now that we have our Rice Krispie all prepared in our pan, we're going to take our giant pretzel ball, and we're just going to stick one in there. We're going to take another one, and stick another one in there, and stick them in there. Now, this is one hefty hammer. I'm going to see if I can try to pull it out. Nope, I don't think I'm able to do it. Well, thank you guys for joining me on this 3-part series of our Fandom episodes. I hope that you can lift the worthy hammer. And I hope to see you guys in the next episode.